以往有事问 Google， 现在 ChatGPT 取而代之，成为不少人的超级秘书。尽管免费试用，但其实有隐藏性的代价。
One subset of that complex problem is AI, which is at the moment in a very transient phase. It's an inflection moment for AI, so it could go either way.And it's very important that we govern that direction to be less energy intensive and more within planetary boundaries.
能源消耗是 AI 使用过程当中看不见的难题。根据专家预估，为生成式 AI 10到50个问题，大约要消耗相当于一瓶宝特瓶500毫升的水。这样的耗水量听起来不多，但上亿人使用，每天成千上万的疑惑要解答，用水量就相当惊人。从微软还有 Google 去年一年的耗水量就能一窥一二。
That its global water use rose by more than a third from 2021 to 2022, climbing to nearly 1.7 billion gallons. For Google, total water consumption at its data centers and offices came in at 5.6 billion gallons in 2022, a 21% increase on the year before. It means that Microsoft's annual water use was the equivalent to more than 2,500 Olympic-sized swimming pools, while for Google, this would be enough water to fill nearly 8,500 pools.
当使用者透过 APP 提问，经过数据传输还有运算提供答案，都会产生大量的热能，因此需要靠水来冷却。
One common method involves the use of cooling towers. This heat rejection device works like a giant air conditioner, typically using water in an evaporation process to expel building heat into the atmosphere.Another technique often used is outside air cooling, or free cooling. This system takes the outside air, which has a lower temperature than inside the building, to directly cool down the servers.
但偏偏很多数据中心的区域气温并不低，根本没有办法利用冷空气调节数据中心的温度。亚洲的资料中心用来降温的耗水量就是美洲资料中心的三倍。Google 先前就传出有意要在乌拉圭打造数据中心。但当地夏天气温大约28、29度，加上又遭逢74年来最严重的干旱，根本无力承担数据中心的水源消耗，一度引发民众不满，走上街头。
In general, the public is getting more knowledgeable and aware of the water issue. If they learn that the big techs are taking away their water resources and they're not getting enough water,Nobody will like it. I think we're going to see more clashes over the water usage in the coming years as well. So this type of risk will have to be taken care of by the companies.
现在美国就有超过5300个数据中心，尽管其他国家的数量相对而言并不多，但随着 AI 使用的大幅成长，这样的数据中心会快速增加。预估到了2027年，全球 AI 需要消耗的水将高达66亿立方公尺，等于美国华盛顿州一整年的用水量。不只是水足迹，根据华尔街日报估算， AI 的碳排放量可能占全球总碳排的2%，甚至跟航空业相等，因此专家认为，在全球力推减碳的当下 ，AI 或许也需要被纳入规范。
I think we are going to see some activity from regulators. There's already some increased requirements coming in the new year, for companies to disclose their water usage in the European Union. And I think that requirement is a necessary one for people to start to appreciate the issue and think about their own.Choices in it.
在还没有找出节能省水的运算方式之前，专家也建议民众在使用生成式 AI 前，可以稍微想一想，是否能改用比较原始的搜寻方式，就能减少 AI 产生大量碳足迹还有水足迹。TVBS 新闻综合报道。
想看最完整的新闻内容，记得下载 TVBS 新闻网 APP。